Assalamu alaikum, this is Parush and today I'm going to show you how to build a scrolling page using ActionScript 3. You see here I have a project and here when I click home it shows home and I can scroll down if I want to by scrolling my mouse and also dragging this scroll bar, and if I go about us here also I can scroll down if I want to, and similarly contact us I can scroll down and also can drag this scroll bar. And today I'm going to show you how to create this project. One of my students named Philip from Philippines has requested me to show this tutorial, so I'm gonna do this. Here I'm using Animate 20, but first I'll select create new, or I'll click file new, and I have got a lot of options here. I'll select ActionScript 3 and then click create, and here I have got the stage, and I'll change the stage dimension to 600 and 600, frame rate would be 35. To build this project, first I have to create my content. Okay, so I'll select this rectangle tool, drag and draw a rectangle, but I'll change the color of my rectangle by selecting this color. I'll drag and draw rectangle, and I'll keep the rectangle width. I'll get rid the line color here, I don't need this. I'll keep my rectangle width 600, exactly the stage, and height would be double 1200, and align it. By selecting my rectangle, right click and convert it to a symbol, and here I'll name this scroll bar, and I have select the resting point left side corner. You must select this registration point here. Okay, and now I have got the content. I'll double click and go inside, and I'll insert two layers, but first I'll rename the first layer saying content, and the second one buttons, and the third one action. And then first I'll lock this content layer, and then I'll go to my component. I'll select this button, drag one button on the stage, and make copy of it, paste it twice, or you can paste it as many times as you want to. Align it right. And I think it will do for this project. And now if I test it, control test, you see it shows level. I'd like to change this level, so first I have to give an instant name of each buttons. So select the first one, I'll give an instant name home button, second one about button, and the third one contact button. Contact button. And now selecting the first layer and first frame of the first layer, I'll go inside and type here stop. Then I'll type home button dot label equal to be home text. That means home button will show this label, and for about button dot label equal to be about us, and now contact button dot equal to be contact us. Save it. I have forgot to save the project, but you have to save it first, so I'll save it now. Better late than never. So save it, and I'll save it on my desktop. And I have a folder, Scallpan. Here I'll go double click and go inside that folder and name this project Scallpan 2. You can name anything you would like to. And if I test it now, I should see my buttons label has been changed. Yes, see home, about us, and contact us. Okay, and now selecting locking the button layer, I'll select the content layer or select the rectangle, right click, convert it into another symbol, name it to content, and registration point doesn't matter. I'll keep it as it is. Okay, double click and go inside. I'll insert a layer, name this layer to content, rename the second layer or lower layer, name it BG, that means background, lock this layer. And on the content layer, I need to have some content, but first I'd like to have some text here. So the text tool and drag and type here a text saying home, and I'll align it right. And now I will insert a frame for BG layer, and here I'll insert a keyframe and change the text saying about us, and insert a frame here for BG, and also insert a keyframe here saying contact us, and now I'll insert another layer, rename this layer saying action. By selecting first frame of the action layer, I'll go inside and type stop. Then I'll copy this keyframe, copy frames, and paste it twice. Save the file, control test it. You see, here I can see my home text, but I'd like to go to the about and also to the contact us. So I'll go back to the scroll bar and selecting the action frame, go inside the action frame, I'll type here and add event listener, mouse event dot click, and the function name mouse click handler. You can name the function anything you'd like to. And now I'll type the function mouse click handler event mouse event, and here I'll use switch statement for this project. So I'll type switch event target, and here I'll type case break, and then copy this case and break, paste it twice, and here in case of home button, and here in case of about button, and here in case of contact button. So in case of home button, I'll type here but first I have to give an instance name of this content movie clip. So I'll type here content, go back to the action panel, I'll type here when home button is click, in case of home button, content dot go to and stop one, stop one, copy this, paste it here for about button, change it to 2, and copy and change it to 3. And now if I test it, it should work. When I click home, it's home as it is home, but when I click about us, you see it's working. And now I'll add some content inside this content movie clip, and it is time consuming, so after adding some text and some photo, I'll come back and show you how to use scroll bar. So here I have added some text and photo on my content movie clip, and now if I test it, control test, and you see it is working fine, but I need to move my buttons below the photo. So go back to scroll bar and unlock the buttons and drag and down this button here, and then lock this buttons layer and go back to the content layer, select this text. I need to put it down a little bit. I think it is okay. If I test it now, you see it is fine, but here on the home text I need to change this text alignment by selecting the text. I'll click left hand side. Now I think it's okay. If I test it, and it is okay, and now I'll add scroll bar here so that I may scroll down this text or these images. So I'll go back to the first scene, and then I'll delete this content. And here, selecting the scroll bar, I'll right click and go to property, and then I'll export it for ActionScript by clicking this checkbox and press OK. And now here I'll insert another layer, rename this layer action, and this layer, rename this layer saying content. And now I'll click this component and I'll select this scroll pane component by dragging it. I've got the component here, and now I change the width and height 600 width and 600 height. I'll align it on my stage, and if I test it, see, nothing happens. But now I'll select the action frame, go inside the action panel and type here stop. But first I have to give an instance name of this scroll component, so I'll type here scroll pen. And now going back to the action panel, I'll type here scroll pane dot source equal to be this scroll bar, same spelling. Type here semicolon, save it. If I test it, it should work. You see? And it is working fine, I think. Change next page, scroll down, and it is working. This page, scroll down, and it is working too. And that's it. This is not so hard tutorial, but you have to have this only one line of code, and all is done. And I think you have learned something from this tutorial. If you like this tutorial, please do subscribe me, put a lot of comments, share this video so that other people may also be benefited for this tutorial. Assalamu alaikum.